فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى today's فائدة benefit. It is from the kitab الزهد لابن أبي عاصم رحمه الله that عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه he said من يدخل مدخل السوء يتهم. عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه he said anyone who enters into a position or a situation which bad speculation can be, then people would speculate bad of him. If you put yourself in a predicament, a situation, where that situation you put yourself into is a bad situation, then it makes the people have bad speculation of you. So in other words, one should be very careful in putting yourself in a position which you kind of allow the crowd and you kind of allow the people to think bad of you. This is what Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu is saying. And this advice of his, this maw'idah, this reminder of his is balighatun, is a very strong reminder, wallahi. And it is required أن ينتبه الإنسان لها, that a person is aware of it and he gives it attention, this concept and this statement of Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه. And that the person, the smart person, that he abstains وأن يحذر العاقل من ورود الأماكن أو المواضع أو إلقاء المقالات والكتابات التي تجلب التهمة له في دينه. That a person is cautious from going to places and putting yourself into positions or writing statements that can push people to having bad assumption of you. Stay away from it and be cautious from that. Because as we know, the people don't have any other way in which they can determine you. وَذَلِكَ أَنَّ النَّاسَ لَيْسَ لَهُمْ إِلَّا الظَّاهِرُ فِي أَحْكَامِهِمْ. The people, they don't have no other way to judge you except from that which seems apparent to them. And our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he illustrated this. وَانْظُرْ إِلَى هَدْيِ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. Look at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's guidance في هذا الباب, in this matter. تجد عجبا, والله, you find amazement. فإنه لما أراد أن يوصل زوجته أم المؤمنين صفية من معتكفه إلى بيته مر به رجلان فأسرعا. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he wanted to make his wife, he wanted to reach his wife to her destination, our mother صفية بنت حيي رضي الله تعالى عنها. And the Prophet at that time, he was doing i'tikaf in the masjid. She came and she visited him. And the Prophet ﷺ was making her reach her destination. Two men went by the Prophet ﷺ. When they saw the Prophet, they started to walk fast. The Messenger ﷺ, he said to the two companions, عَلَى رِسْلِكُمَا. Slow down. إِنَّهَا صَفِيَّةُ بِنْتُ حُيَيْ. This is Safiya bint Huyay, the Prophet's wife. فَقَالَا, the two companions, they said, Subhanallah ya Rasulallah, exalted is Allah, O Messenger of Allah. Meaning, we would not think that of you. Because the companions, they were nurtured to think good of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Then the Prophet reminded them and said to them, إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ يجري من الإنسان مجرى الدم. إن الشيطان يجري من الإنسان مجرى الدم وإني لخشيت أن يقذف في قلوبكما شرا أو قال شيئا. The Prophet said that the shaitan, He runs inside the person in their veins, the same way that the blood runs in the veins. And I was scared that shaitan may throw in your hearts some evil. He might put doubt in your hearts. In another wording, the Prophet said, he might throw in your hearts something. My brothers and sisters, فَإِذَا كَانَ هَذَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ فَمَظَّنُّ بِمَنْ دُونَهُ. If that's the messenger of Allah, who would not commit sins, major sins, and things like that, the Prophet would not walk with a woman, عليه الصلاة والسلام, that isn't lawful for him, and would not do that, then what do you think of somebody other than that? Al-Imam Hafiz ibn Hajar, in his Kitab Fathul Bari, he brought the statement of Imam al-Shafi'i, that Imam al-Shafi'i commented and he spoke about this hadith, the hadith of Safiyyah bint Huyay, in which the Prophet ﷺ told the companions to walk slow. علق الإمام الشافعي رحمه الله على ذلك بقوله إنما قال لهما ذلك لأنه خاف عليهما الكفر إن ظن به التهمة. The Prophet said to them that which he said to the two men because he feared for them disbelief. If they were to think bad of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, if they thought evil of the Prophet, then disbelief is what they would have fallen to. فبادر إلى إعلامهما نصيحة لهما قبل أن يقذف الشيطان في نفوسهما شيئا يهلكان به. The Prophet ﷺ, he hastened to notifying them, and he did that نصيحة لهما. He was doing it out of advice for them. Before Shaytan throws in their heart something and they become destroyed because of that. And ولتوضيح صلة موعظة الفاروق بهذا الحديث العظيم, to show you the strong bond between the advice that Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه gave and the relationship between the hadith of Safiyyah bint Huyay. Ibn Hajar in his Fathul al-Bari, the same fourth volume, page 280, he also brought the statement of Ibn al-Daqiq al-Eid. Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, and he said, قال ابن الدقيق العيد, ابن الدقيق العيد said, رحمه الله, وهذا متأكد في حق العلماء ومن يقتدى به فلا يجوز لهم أن يفعلوا فعلا يوجب سوء الظن بهم. He said, this hadith is highly emphasized on the people of knowledge. And everyone who is taken as a role model, the people follow. فَلَا يَجُوزُ لَهُمْ, it is not permissible for the scholars and the people who are followed and people are following you. It is not permissible for you. أَنْ يَفْعَلُوا فِعْلًا, to do an action. يُوجِبُ سُوءَ الظَّنِّ بِهِمْ, that necessitates bad assumption on you. وَإِنْ كَانَ لَهُمْ فِيهِ مَخْلَصٌ, and if there is a way you can take, go out of it, and you can stay away from it. لِأَنَّ ذَلِكَ سَبَبٌ, the reason this is something you shouldn't do is because ذَلِكَ سَبَبٌ إِلَىٰ إِبْطَالِ الْإِنْتِفَاعِ بِعِلْمِهِمْ وَمِنْ ثَمَّ قَالَ بَعْضُ الْعُلَمَاءِ يَنْبَغِي لِلْحَاكِمِ أَنْ يُبَيِّنَ لِلْمَحْكُومِ عَلَيْهِ وَجْهَ الْحُكْمِ إِذَا كَانَ خَافِيًا نَفْيًا لِلْتُهْمَةِ. Because this would necessitate from the people to not benefit from you. They'll stop benefiting from you. And the scholars, they said that, some of the scholars, they said, it is something that the one who judges, a qadi, a judge, if he passes a law onto somebody, for instance, he says that you are going to be, this is the ruling of the Sharia on you. أَنْ يُبَيِّنَ لِلْمَحْكُومِ عَلَيْهِ وَجْهَ الْحُكْمِ, he should clarify to him how the ruling was brought. إِذَا كَانَ خَافِينَ, if it's hidden. And it's something that the person who the judgment is being put on him doesn't know, you have to clarify for them. Why? نَفْيًا لِلتُّهْمَةِ To stay away from assumption and speculation. Because he could think that you are doing this because you have a personal agenda against him. So you have to get rid of the assumptions and the speculations. And you have to clarify the hukum for him. If the hukum is خَافِيًا, if it's hidden. And he goes on to say, وَمِنْ هُنَا يَظْهَرُ خَطَأَ مَنْ يَتَظَاهَرُ بِمَظَاهِرِ السُّوءِ وَيَعْتَذِرُ بِأَنَّهُ يُجَرِّبُ بِذَلِكَ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ وَقَدْ عَظُمَ الْبَلَاءُ بِهَذَا الصِّنْفِ وَاللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ. And so this is a maw'idha, a reminder, brothers, that we need to understand its importance. It is something that, wallahi, when I read it, I personally realized this is something that applies to me before anyone else. That I stay away from مُعَاضِعُ التُّهَمْ, places that bring doubts, that somebody can think bad of you. And if I do go into a position or a situation where it might look wrong, that I clarify it for the people. So it's clear that they know and they're aware of it. And I conclude there بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ الْكَرِيمِ for today's benefit. سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ بِحَمْدِكَ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْهِ.